Hey guys, Alina here, and you know what? I recently realized that not a lot of people know how accessible Russia is and how disabled people live here. So today I'm gonna try my best to show you around, explain some things, and I want you to know that it's gonna be based on my experiences only, and also I'm gonna focus more on wheelchair users because that's what I know about, and I'm not gonna talk about accessibility for visually impaired people or any other disabilities. Please take everything what I say with a grain of salt. And also, I have my friend Caesar who's gonna be helping me filming this, and he's from United States, so he's also gonna share a bit of his perspective on how things in Russia are. Hey.
What's up?
Just rolling, okay? Rolling. Talking about accessibility, the first thing that comes to mind is ramps, because it's also like one of the easiest and one of the most essential things. It's important to have ramps to banks, to post offices, just things that it's hard to live without, you know, but also it's important to have to some fun places. Now I'm at the central street of St. Petersburg, Nevsky Prospect, and we are gonna see how is the ramp situation here. So right away there are so many spaces without the ramp, but there's still a place to like walk around, and luckily even this underground pass has this kind of a huge ramp.
Even international companies like Starbucks don't have any ramps, because of course, while disabled people would want to drink a coffee, right?
Yeah.
But still, the majority of places, they have stairs and no ramps. And I remind you, it's the central street of St. Petersburg. And St. Petersburg is the second largest city.
We are approaching a pretty sucky crossroad, and it's the center of the city. Like, it's the main street, but it's still like pretty bad, and I understand it's all old, but come on, just make it freaking accessible.
We tried to go around, but that was too dangerous to close the traffic, and so my friend had to push me backwards in order to overcome the steps.
This is one of the very common ramps that we have here. It's not really possible to use it by yourself, and even if when someone helps you, it could be dangerous and pretty difficult as well. In St. Petersburg, it's pretty easy to get around them, but in Moscow, it's very difficult sometimes, and they have so many of them, and they have a lot of underground passes. I had a date in Moscow, and we were having like a walk around the city center, and the guy, he was actually very shocked that there are so many ramps like that and there is no way to go around. So he was like, dang, I'm gonna complain to the government tomorrow, like file a complaint. And thank God he was very muscular and he was able to like get me around, but you know, It's difficult, it's definitely difficult, and it's impossible to do it by yourself. So don't judge me when I like fit guys, because it's not for nothing, okay? To be completely fair to this situation, a lot of people are willing to help, and even now, standing here for just a couple of minutes, already two people approached me, and one guy even talked in English because he thought apparently I'm not from here. People are pretty like helpful, but still, disabled people, we always like, we want to be independent, we don't want to count on other people. And what if you are sociophobic, but you still need to communicate with people, you know? So yeah. Of public transportation in St. Petersburg is metro. Actually, a few stations in St. Petersburg are
accessible, only the newer ones, but every station has a number where you can call and require an assistance. So you will tell them where you are and somebody will come out and get you and help you. So we decided to use the metro and I'm gonna call that number and see if the assistance will actually help us and how it's gonna be. Let's try doing that. They say I called to an informational center of the metro. They're recording all the calls. Oh, and they actually speak English too. Wow. Здравствуйте, я звоню, потому что я на коляске, я, ну, вот увидела этот номер, чтобы звоните вам помогут. Я на Маяковской. Вот. Да, да, да. She asked where I'm going, and I told her, and she said she will pass the information to people who work at this station and asked how long do I need to wait, and she's like, well, I don't know, we'll just tell the information and I don't know. But let's wait. Now it's 1:52 p.m. and we'll see when they actually come to rescue me. Of course, I didn't miss out on the opportunity to talk to people, and they work very smoothly, so I'm grateful for them, and it's cool that disabled people in wheelchairs can still use public transportation, but I don't like it in a way that you still depend on other people, you still waste more time, and it just would have been better with the elevator and not with the Z sign. I hate it. So while it's good that people in wheelchairs can use the metro, it still could have been better.
The time we are outside, we haven't seen one other person in a wheelchair. So, I don't know, I think it says a lot.
Life in St. Petersburg, it's cold, depressing, yet beautiful.
So let's just jump in real quick to the mall now.
Let's do it.
Yes. And the majority of them are pretty accessible, but we'll see what will be there.
So we found the restroom for disabled people, finally, which is a pretty rare thing in Russia. And I think I'm supposed to like call here to be let in because they are closed. And oh my god. Hello? Hello? I don't know what's going on. Honestly. Hey. Дверь открыта. Can you try to open it? Да, спасибо. So now it's open. Yay. A lot of the time non-disabled people just choose to go to disabled bathrooms, which is pretty wrong. I'll take a piss. She'll wait here, okay? So we are taking a coffee now, and you know what? It's just like there are so many issues regarding disability. Like for example, the money issue, we also have like the compensation, monthly compensation. The amount of it depends on where you live and what level of disability you have. We have three. One is the most severe and I have the second. So I get every month like $160. To compare, for example, the rent, the cheapest rent starts from $180, so it's not possible to pay only for, at least for the rent, even you still need to work. But the thing is that the best option is working only remotely because places aren't really accessible. I even had an occasion where I almost got the job, but it was on the fifth floor, like the office was on the fifth floor with no parking nearby, and I knew that I wouldn't be able to do such like such a workout 5 days per week. So I didn't take this job, and it was really sad to me because I wanted it and they wanted me. So another issue is just like with how people kind of treat you. A lot of people just stare at you, and I don't know, in my case they stare maybe because I'm so pretty, but sometimes this curiosity is just very impolite because I'm a person too, and most of the time I don't notice this, but sometimes I'm just like, I want to blend in and be invincible and just kind of not communicate and not be stared at, okay? So that's just really something that you have to work through kind of in yourself and kind of build this confidence too, because sometimes it gets too much. There are a lot of issues and I can talk for hours about it, but I hope I gave you at least a little bit of impression of how things are. And I also want to ask my friend Caesar.
Yes, I am Caesar.
Did you notice a difference between accessibility in Russia and in the United States?
Yes, it's kind of obvious. Again, walking down the street here in comparison to walking down the street in the US. For example, whenever you come to an establishment or some kind of building in the US, everything seems to be more accessible to any kinds of people. Again, disabled, whatever the disabilities may be. Whereby here in Russia, it's, well, you'll see stairs, you'll see ramps that aren't of the best quality. So yeah, it's kind of obvious just walking down the street.
In general, can you say that you notice more people in wheelchairs in United States comparing to Russia?
If it's in a very, in a big city, for example, yeah, because there's a lot of pedestrians. So yeah, you'll see it. But in the US, we have more of a driving everywhere type of trend. So for that reason, we might actually not see a lot of people in wheelchairs, but that doesn't mean that they aren't there. So it goes without saying that, you know, a society should essentially adjust itself for to make it everything accessible to everyone, you know, disability, with disabilities or none. So yeah.
So I was mentioning people staring, and I know it kind of throws off some people who hang out with me for the first time and they notice it, and a lot of the times they tell me like, oh my god, why are they staring at you so much? So have you noticed this when we hung out for the first time?
Yeah, obviously. And yeah, of course, it kind of goes without saying that whenever we ourselves are just like pedestrians just walking, we tend to focus on things that, as we perceive to be slightly odd or out of place. So yeah, naturally, again, if you're okay with attention, you'll do fine. Again, it's a matter of confidence. But if you're not, then you'll definitely feel uncomfortable. But after some time, that feeling of kind of subsides. And you know, again, you get comfortable being, you know, with someone, for example, in Alina's situation.
So you think I should date someone really confident?
Yeah, I personally didn't have an issue with it, but it is obvious that people stare, children stare especially a lot, and it goes without saying they're curious. But yeah, overall, it's just a matter, I think, again, confidence and curiosity. You know, curiosity for those and confidence for yourself. But yeah.
So guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was useful and fun. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And also, I set up a Patreon, so you can also follow me there and you'll get access to my videos very early on. And see you in the next videos. Bye.